This video talks about logarithmic amplifier built with op amps. A log amplifier is an amplifier in which the output voltage is the natural log of the input voltage. It is used in analog computer audio synthesis methods and to perform mathematical operations such as multiplication and raising to the power. The properties of logarithms are derived from the exponent rules. These are some important logarithmic properties which we want to talk about here. Here you see the general expression of log base a of something, but we are going to use the natural logarithm, so log base e, where e is the Euler's number. You can immediately realize that through these rules you can perform addition instead of multiplication, subtraction instead of division, and multiplication instead of the raising to the power. As we saw, through log amplifiers we can build a multiplication stage. Let's see how. We want to multiply m times n, so first we calculate the natural log of the numbers by applying the log amp. Second, we add the two numbers, and here we exploit the log property because this is equal to the log of m times n. Third, we calculate the antilog to get the product of the initial numbers. Of course, the antilog is the exponentiation. So the circuit performs a multiplication using three components: log and antilog amplifier and an analog adder. All the operations can be performed using operational amplifiers. Here you see the logarithmic amplifier. It is made by an operational amplifier with a negative feedback. In the feedback loop there is a BJT used in a transdiode configuration, so the collector and the base of the BJT have the same voltage. That is because the base of the BJT is grounded and the collector has voltage V minus, which is equal to voltage V plus, which in turn is grounded. If the op-amp works in linear region, the V minus is equal to V plus, which is one of the main properties of op-amps. So, with this configuration, the base emitter voltage of the BJT is equal to minus V out. As we know from the BJT equation, the collector current is this, from which we get this other equation for VBE. Knowing that the current IC has to be the same in these two branches because no current goes in the op-amp, we can say that IC is equal to Vin divided by R, because V minus is a virtual ground and Vin drops entirely on R. So putting this relation into the BJT equation and remembering that VBE is equal to minus Vout, we get this final equation. You see the output voltage is proportional to the natural log of the input voltage. Of course, we see also a temperature dependency because of the thermal voltage VT and the saturation current IS. Another important aspect is the biasing of the BJT. In order to keep it forward biased, Vin must be always positive, making Vout negative. Vin is indeed applied to the inverting input of the op-amp, thus a positive Vin produces a negative Vout. The antilog amplifier working is similar, but we put a transdiode BJT in the inverting input and we put a resistor on the feedback. The current on the BJT is this, and it is proportional to the Euler's number to the power of VEB, the voltage on the meter base junction. The IC current flows into the feedback in this direction. VEB is equal to the input voltage Vin. The output voltage is equal to the opposite of RF times IC. So the output voltage is this, and it is proportional to the power of the input voltage Vin. Here also, the input voltage must be positive, and the output voltage must be negative. Here, an op-amp used for adding two voltages, V1 and V2. The current through R1 is this, and the current through R2 is this one. So the current of the feedback is this. The output voltage is the opposite of the voltage dropping on the feedback, so Vout is equal to minus RF times the current. In the case R1 is equal to R2, we see the output voltage is proportional to the sum of V1 and V2. So now we have all the components needed for our little analog multiplier circuit. Here, the basic analog multiplier using log and anti-log amplifier. In the first stage, we operate the log of the two input voltages. The second stage performs the sum, and the third stage performs the antilog. The last stage inverts and cancels out the constant factor we don't want. So, at the end of the first stage, we find these signals. At the end of the second stage, there is this one, assuming that R1 equals R2 equals R. At the end of the third stage, we have this signal. You see, there is the product of the two voltages, as we wanted, but there is a constant factor and a minus sign. So, we need the last inverting stage, and the final output is this. In order to cancel out the constant factor, we make the ratio R3 over R4 equal to R times IS. In this way, we get the desired product. As we said, this circuit has many issues. It needs a compensation for the temperature dependency, and it needs two rectifiers because V1 and V2 cannot be negative. So in the end, this is just a single quadrant multiplication. Moreover, we made some approximation for the collector current of the BJT, for example. So this circuit is just to give a glimpse on the working of analog logarithmic operations. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.